In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to create a JavaScript notification pop-up system, which will start with a button that will request notification access. And if we click allow here, then you can see that we get this basic notification. And if we close it and we actually open a new tab, then we're getting another notification for us to come back. And if you're new here, then please sub to my channel, but let's get started. So the first thing I'm going to do is create a button with a class of NotifBTN like this, and I'm gonna copy it so I don't have to write it down. And now I'm gonna write click me for the text, and you can write whatever you want. Make sure they have a JavaScript file and you link it here. And what we're gonna do now is we're gonna find it first. So document.querySelector, and then we're gonna add an event listener, and it's gonna be on click like this. And now inside of our function here, what we're going to do is we're going to write notification.requestPermission.then. And now here we're going to write perm, and that's basically permission. And then inside of here, what we're going to do is create the notification. But before we do, we can actually see if it works. So let's actually go here and open it with Live Server. And now I'm going to make sure that I'm going to reset the permission first, like this. And now if I click it, then you can see that I get this permission pop-up. And if I click allow, then now we're going to be able to get notifications. And now before we actually create the notification itself, what we're going to do is we're going to make sure that the user allowed our permission here for notifications. So what we're going to do is we're going to create an if statement, which will make sure that our permission is equal to granted. And now let's actually alert here that it's granted to see if it works. So let's write user allowed notifications like this. And now if I go back here and I reload, after, when I click it, you can see that I get this notification. So that means that it works. And if I actually reset the permission here and reload and I click block, and I click it, then you can see that we don't get that message. Now make sure that you receive notifications like this if you clicked on block here and click on allow. But now let's actually create the notification itself. So what we're gonna write is new notification, and then between our brackets here, this is basically like the title of the notification. So let's write notification title and see if it worked. So if we go back here and then we click here, then you can see that we get this notification. And we can actually add some body text too. So let's do that. And after our notification title here, we're going to add a comma and then two curly brackets. And then inside of them, we're going to write body. And then here we're going to write the body text. So I'm going to write sub to web dev. There we go. And now if we go back here and click it, then you can see that now we have the title here and then this text underneath. And we can also add an icon here. So let's do that. Now what we're going to do is after our body, we're going to add a comma and then write icon. I have mine saved right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to write the path here. So logo.png, and you're going to write your path. Gonna add a comma here too, and if we click it again, then you can see that now we've added an icon. And what we're gonna do now is create an event listener, which will check when the user leaves the website, and then it will create a new notification, which will tell it to come back. And when we actually click it, it will redirect us to our website. So what we're gonna do is first create an object, which is gonna be equal to our new notification. So let notification, and let's add the event listener. So document.addEventListener, and then it's going to be equal to visibility change. Let's create the function, and now inside of it, we're going to create this if statement, which will check if the state is equal to hidden. So document.visibilityState, and if that's equal to hidden, there we go. Then we're going to create this notification right here. So notification is equal to new notification. The title is going to be, are you sure you want to leave, like this. And now the body is going to say, please come back, like this. And let's see if it works. So if we go back here, we'll click it, then this notification shows up, but then when I leave our website, then we get this new notification. And we can actually add this feature that when we click it, it will redirect us or open this website here. So now let's do that. And what we're going to do is under here, we're going to write notification.addEventListener. And this one's just going to be on click. And inside of our function here, we're going to write window.open. And then inside of here, we're going to write the URL of our website. So we're going to write this here. And let's see if it works. So we're going to go back here. Let's reset our notifications, permissions, and everything. Let's reload. When I click it, we can click on allow here, which will send us to this notification. If I leave our website, then we get this new notification. And if we click it, then it will open our website again. And this is going to be for this video. So if you guys enjoyed it, then like this video, sub to my channel for more content like this. Leave a comment down below if you have any video requests, and see you next video.